Enfusion.
You got 18 fighters from all over the globe. We have them train together. We have them live together. We have them eat together. We have them fight together. But only one gets to win it. So it's now or never. This is the battle of a warrior. Let it be known. And my advice is either go hard or go home. You better step up to the challenge or you'll get dismissed. And you don't get a second chance, homie. This is it. Koh Samui is where we train the best. Welcome to Thailand. Let's see if you can pass the test. Which one of these fighters is a champion? Who's gonna rise up and show them that it can be done? $40,000, now who wants it most? Let's see if you can do more than brag and boast. Kickboxing meets discipline. Step inside the ring, let's go finish him.
Welcome to Enfusion Reality number 4, where 16 of the best heavyweight fighters from all over the world compete until there is one left. They will be coached by 5 beautiful team captains who will also fight each other in this tournament. Fighters will sleep, eat, live and train together in Resort Super Pro Samui, a necessity to visit for all people who love combat sports. Super Pro Samui is located on the beautiful island of Koh Samui. The island has something for everybody: sun, sea, rest, culture, and above all, good parties. The co-host of the show is 14 times world champion, Julie Kitchen. Enfusion is the brainchild of the host, Edwin Van Os, coach, manager, and former trainer of many world-class Thai boxers. Last time on Enfusion. Andrew beat Matei by TKO with a strong low kick. A big fight between Mo and Tom. Tensions between Manal and Denise.
I think that he has a little crush. Yes, please.
The fight between Kirk and Alexander. With a victory for Kirk as he moves on to the quarterfinals. Andrew Thompson moved on to the quarterfinals. And Kirk Ruber moved on to the quarterfinals. And Daniel Sam versus Iggy McGowan.
Iggy, like to challenge Daniel.
Iggy wanted to fight Daniel because he is the biggest contender.
Good luck to you, man. The tournament ends now, yeah?
An introduction of Daniel Sam.
My name is Daniel Sam and I'm from London, UK. My height is 6'5" and I'm weighing in at 120 kilos. My fight record is 29 fights and 21 wins.
My name is Daniel the Warrior Sam. I'm from London, England, UK. Fighting here on the Enfusion reality show. It's a good, very good show, very good tournament set up. I'm looking forward to the first fight, putting on a good show for the crowd and for the audience and for the viewers at home. So yeah, looking forward to it.
So big.
Like a bear.
Yeah.
Daniel draws a lot of attention from the tourists.
Anytime, Hollywood, done.
Yeah.
Don't worry about us, Dan, we'll wait.
Sorry guys. Life at home is very good. I've got a very understanding wife, you know, who understands that I do need to be training twice a day, you know, 6 days a week. I need to be travelling across to Amsterdam when I'm training as well. So she does a lot for me, you know, being there for me. I try and help her as much as I can with the kids, you know, to and from school, helping them in the house as well. So my daily life is very, very busy. There's not any one day that I'm not on the go, doing this, doing that. I also teach classes as well. So as well as my own training, I teach various classes throughout the week as well. Every single day of the week, I'm teaching a class. So on top of doing my two sessions of training, I'm also teaching a class.
I think when you first meet Daniel, he potentially gives a bit of distance. Obviously, he's here to win. He's very focused on what he wants to do and how he wants to do things. The more you get to know him, the more his personality comes out, the more he gives you, the more he offers you of Daniel Sam. Not Daniel Sam the fighter, but actually Daniel himself, and he's a great guy.
My name's Iggy McGowan, and I'm from Australia. I'm 5'11", and my weight is 93 kilos. Fight record is 16 fights, 14 wins, and 9 KOs. I'm blessed to come from an amazing family. I have, you know, the best parents, you know, that anyone could ask for. And to top that off, I'm one of seven kids, and I've just got the best brothers and sisters, you know, the tightest family, most loving, you know, supportive. So, you know, that above everything else is, it's just such a blessing, so. It was in Wagga, yeah, that I met my first Muay Thai trainer, Jason Lee Plum, and that was when I was 15 years old, and that's really when I first found someone that made me feel like I wasn't alone on this planet, if that makes sense. Jason was, you know, my older brother, mentor, trainer, you know, just, yeah, he really taught me a lot, you know, not just about Muay Thai, but about life, you know. So yeah, that's where my Muay Thai career started. Just over 2 years ago now, Jason passed away. So he's not with us, not in the physical form anyway. And so to commemorate him, both his mother, Deb Plum, and his sister, Chantel, and a number of other friends, Jason's nickname was Batman. So we got a Batman tattoo with Jason's date of birth and forever. Because, you know, and as Jason said, he was, you know, he was very wise. He had things figured out quite a lot. Time is an illusion, you know, time is an illusion, which it is. And if we've ever existed, we'll always exist, because there is no end to energy. So, and this is something that I, you know, not just try and convince myself of, but I simply know that it is the case. You know, I feel his presence, you know, so often, you know, and especially here in Thailand now, you know, and with an opportunity like this, you know, Jason is here, you know, with me, yeah.
I work for a charity organisation called Fight for Peace, based in North Woolwich. It's a youth project set up for youngsters between the ages of 11 to 25, and we teach them boxing, kickboxing, mixed martial arts, jiu-jitsu, and gym sessions as a way to try and encourage the youngsters from East London to get off the streets and, you know, to try and direct them onto a better path, a better future. So as well as teaching them sports, we also give them education programs as well. So we teach them English, math, science, and general stuff like that. And then from there, we also help them to try and get jobs. So we help them out with CVs, interview techniques, and try and, as much as we can, you know, try and push them forward. It's a very good project. It started in Brazil, in some of the favelas in Brazil, and now they've got another branch in London. So that takes up a lot of my time, but I thoroughly enjoy it because the classes are very busy. And you know, it's me working with youngsters. So as well as seeing my kids, I see other youngsters as well who are very vibrant, you know, very energetic. They keep me on my toes, they keep me young. You know, I get told, oh, Daniel, you're old, you can't do this anymore. So, you know, I'm trying to keep up with them. I'm teaching them stuff, they're teaching me stuff, and, you know, we're always learning and ever progressing. So that's through my daily life. On the weekends, I work at clubs, I do security work at a club, so I don't have to change my face from being, you know, the martial arts instructor to from a fighter to being Mr. Serious at a club, you know, where I'm working to keep the people safe, do my job, you know, make my money, and then go home at the end of the night and see the family again.
I call him Big Brother Daniel Sam because he's like, it's like I like messing with him, you know what I mean? He is, yeah. I always try to knock him down a few notches because he is actually that good. He is actually one of the best fighters here. He's big, he's strong, he's agile, smart guy, very funny, a lot of fun to be around. He calls me the Yankee, you know, because he feels Canada and USA are basically the same thing.
Iggy always has his necklace with him, so he has his sister close to his heart. The necklace has her fingerprint molded on it.
Just over a year ago, my older sister, Tess Bernadette McGowan, who, you know, is, yeah, Tess is here with me now. I know that she is. Tess passed away from melanoma.
Before the most important fight of Iggy's career, he goes to the temple to be in contact with his sister and coach.
I know that every time I do enter the ring, that I have the best corner. May not be physical, but it wouldn't matter if, you know, I mean, I know in the show there's a competition and, you know, you know, sometimes you may only be left with your coach in the corner. All of that, you know, it actually had humoured me a few times, and I'll share with you why. Because it doesn't matter, because I know that my corner's full. People can't see that, but I know that I've got the best people I could choose in my corner. So how could I lose?
Iggy's cool. He's like, he's a good dude. He's good. I don't know a lot about him from before here, but Australia and New Zealand always stick together. When we're out of our countries, we always stick together, so he had to come on my team.
What motivates me to get up every day when I'm tired and when I'm not tired, you know, this competition is, we're here training at Super Pro, and for me that's exactly what it is. You know, one of the many trainers I've got said to me that the difference between an amateur and a pro is that an amateur does what they want to do, whereas a pro does what they have to do, you know. So when I see my kids in the morning, that always motivates me to get up and do what I have to do, whether I'm tired, whether I don't feel like doing it, you know. I want a day off sometimes, I feel like being lazy, but if I know I've got to do something, it has to be done. Simple as that. There's no ifs, buts or maybes about it. It has to be done.
Big Daniel is walking around imposing himself, making his presence known. I think he's a big striker. His cardio looks good. He looks like he's taking it very seriously. I think he wants this pretty badly too.
For my children, I'd like them to become anything that makes them happy. You know, at first I wanted to say that, you know, I all want them to be fighters. I want them to be, you know, to follow myself. But I want them to be able to defend themselves, you know, mentally as well as physically. So I would like them to learn some form of a martial art as they can have as a backup. You know, for one, for the general fitness, you know, two, for the self-confidence it gives. Well, I understand the benefits from doing it myself and being able to teach it and see the difference in the youngsters that I teach it to. I can see the difference in the self-confidence that they have, the interaction and, you know, the general teamwork. It's the same that we've got here in Infusion. You know, we've been here with total strangers for maybe 3 or 4 days, and, you know, the connections that you can make instantly with people, because we've all got that common goal. So that's something that I'd definitely like for my kids to have. But then anything that makes them happy.
The worst part of training for me is sprints, but it has to be done, so you must do a sprint.
I sent a message to Mum this morning to let her know, you know, what I was able to do today, you know, to be able to go to a temple, to in the message I said, you know, to be, you know, with myself and to be with Tess and Jason. And when Mum knows that I am, you know, in touch with my spiritual side, she knows that I am, that all is well, you know, that that I'm happy, that I'm safe. Life is a gift, and so those things that have happened in the past have been awakenings to me, to that we're here in this physical form for a brief time, you know? So it's to be enjoyed and lived to the full. So yeah, in answer to what of those things, those, you know, those huge events, you know, or happenings, how have they changed me? You know, they've helped awaken me to embrace life, to embrace everything. What people call fear, to embrace it.
But yeah. About you, Iggy? I read something interesting about you on Google the other day.
On Google?
you be Googling him?
I Googled all of you.
Did you?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, my last fight, which was on Friday the 30th, just gone. My opponent in the first round, Shane Bredag, he threw a big heavy right thigh kick, which I checked hard, and it snapped his tibia and fibula, so straight through about there, clean in half, and then he's gone to stand back on, and it's collapsed. So that was unfortunate for Shane. In a fight, you know, this is my mindset anyway, I'm sure it's everyone's. I'm trying to kill my opponent. Like, that's what I'm doing.
That's what it is.
I'm trying to kill them. But as soon as that bell goes, you know, as soon as that round's finished, as soon as the fight's over, I have nothing but complete respect. You know, that's a human being, you know, and so to see someone in agony, you know, on the ground like that, like in after the last fight, you know, it's not a nice, not a nice thing. And so I made contact with Shane the next day. Actually, I messaged him. Wasn't sure if I'd hear back, but just to let him know that I was thinking of him and wished him a speedy recovery. And yeah, we've been in communication since. You know, he got out nearly a week later.
Yeah.
And now has a steel rod from his ankle to his knee, but he's in good spirits. So yeah.
Hello, fighters. For this difficult challenge, I've selected two strong guys. Iggy, you're the lucky one. And of course you, Daniel. Julie will explain you the rules.
Okay, your challenge today is tire flipping. So we've got this nice big tire there. Looks so deceiving, it's really, really heavy. And you have to flip it up to the line and you will be timed and the fastest person will win. Good luck.
Okay, Iggy, you can decide if you want to be first or you leave the honor to Daniel, who's going to be first. What do you choose?
What do I choose? I get that decision.
Yeah, you get a decision if you want to be first or second.
That's lovely. I'm a gentleman, so I'll let Daniel go first.
Okay, please step forward, Daniel. Daniel, are you ready? 3, 2, 1, start!
Before each bout, the fighters will have to compete against each other in a challenge to determine who will have the advantage of having two teammates to help in the corner along with their team captain. The loser will only have their team captain working the corner.
That should be enough, or you give him a chance?
We'll see.
Of course it is.
Okay.
It's a nice workout. Good stuff.
3, 2, 1, go!
Team, you seem to be on a bit of a run with good luck with your challenges. How are you feeling? Well done.
Yeah, I feel good. It was a good challenge, nice hard challenge. We did a lot of strength work this morning. You know, this kind of topped off our training circuit. It was a good challenge. Yeah, that tyre is a lot heavier than it looks, yeah. And it looks heavy.
Yeah, it's really heavy. Do you think it's taking too much out of you for when lead up to the fight night?
No, not at all. We do a lot of hard training, so you know, this is just complementing the training that we do. We could do this all day, you know, okay. It's real good.
Would you say it's a start to how it's going to roll on the fight night by you winning this challenge?
Yeah, definitely. You know, we get three cornermen, you know, it's going to be an advantage, but it's one that we need to press home. You know, regardless, one cornerman or three cornermen, I'm going to knock him out in the fight anyway, so it doesn't really matter.
You're not going to need your corner then?
No.
Okay, and what round do you predict that you'll knock him out?
I'm not going to predict a round, but it's going to go by knockout.
And did you want to like stamp your authority with the win on the challenge just to prove that you are the stronger of the two?
Not really in the challenge, no, because you know, this isn't a fight. You know, this is just it's a strength challenge. But you know, on fight night it'll be different. You know, I'll be different, he'll be a different person in the ring, so
it's a bit like David and Goliath with the height, you're the biggest guy in the competition. I think Iggy might be one of the shortest. So
Well, I'll make sure I press home that advantage, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, good luck. Are you really proud of your teammate?
Yeah, of course, still doing well. Continuing to train hard, bond well. Yeah, we're loving it.
Thank you. Injury-free from the challenge?
Yeah, yep. And yeah, Miriam and the other team members said, you know, just, you know, don't hurt yourself, your body. But I wanted to do it anyway because it looked like fun.
Yeah, you enjoyed it.
Oh yeah, for sure. And how do I feel about having...
Just Miriam in your corner?
Absolutely fine.
Okay, you're happy.
Absolutely. You know, confident with just Miriam in my corner. And I also have two other people. They're not in the physical.
Okay.
But they'll be in my corner as well.
Yeah. Okay.
And that's my sister and my first trainer. Jason Plum. So I've always got them in my corner.
They'll be there with you.
Yeah, so my corner's full already.
Yeah.
Well.
Yeah.
So, yeah, but well done to Daniel.
Yeah.
Daniel won his challenge, he gets the luxury suite with sea view the night before the fight. Unfortunately, it's not the same for Iggy.
From the red team, please step forward. Iggy from Australia. From the white team, Daniel. From England.
Time for the open weight weigh-in.
97 kilograms. On the 25 kilogram.
What I expect of the fight, I expect to knock him out. Out clean. I'm here to win the tournament. You know, this is the first fight on that journey to do so. So I want to go and put on a good performance. You know, show that I'm here. I've been training hard for this tournament, and you know, absolutely smash through him tomorrow.
Physically, I'm probably the smallest in the competition.
Do you see that as a weakness or a strength?
I don't see it as a weakness whatsoever. No, I know what I'm capable of.
And can you just sum that up quickly?
Limitless.
It's going to be an exciting fight. It's going to be excellent. I'm really looking forward to it.
How are you feeling?
Feeling good. Can't wait to get in the ring and start working. It's going to be good.
Have you got a prediction for your fight tonight?
Yeah, I'm winning by knockout. Yeah, that's my prediction.
Pardon?
That's my prediction, yeah.
Your prediction, do you know what round?
No, it doesn't matter what round. As soon as I hit him, he's going to know about the power. Then I'm just going to start breaking him down.
Okay, and are you looking for the knockout so you can save yourself for the finals?
Well, that'd be one way to look at it, yeah. Save some energy, you know, and then conserve some for the main event tournament in 5 days.
This is not even a contest. Daniel Sam is going to smash Iggy. Iggy is not going to stand a chance against Daniel Sam. One thing Iggy said to me and Matei, which I thought was really funny, Matei asked him, he said, why? Why would you do this? Why would you challenge him? Iggy looked and said, it just felt right. Did it? It's not going to feel right when Daniel Sam smashes you. Thanks, by the way, for giving Daniel Sam a bye into the next round.
Looking nice and relaxed there.
Yeah, I am. Nice and calm and relaxed and ready to turn it on when needs to do.
Are you just having a little bit of a pre-fight massage, or have you got a problem with your arm?
No, it's just to get the blood flowing. Just, yeah, a little pre-fight massage. Little quick loosen up, yeah.
Well, good luck this evening. I'm sure you'll do great.
I will. Thank you.
I give Iggy a good chance as anyone against Daniel. It gives them both a chance against each other. Iggy's got great heart, great skills to take Daniel. Just because Daniel's big doesn't mean everything.
Daniel versus Iggy. I don't understand why Iggy choose for Daniel. I asked him, he said, it's the feeling he had, he told me. But I think Daniel will finish this one with a low kick to his head.
I don't think there is a clear favorite at this point. I think Daniel he's trying to intimidate everybody with his size and his manner.
We got Iggy about to step in with the biggest guy of the tournament. Are you nervous?
I'm nervous. I'm always nervous for fights, whether it's my own or other people's that I'm close to. So, but nerves are good. So, yeah.
Daniel Sam said he's looking for a knockout, not predicting what round.
His own.
Well, that's the classic David and Goliath, Daniel and Iggy. Iggy's going to have to knock Daniel out. And I think he'll do that in the first round.
Please welcome to the red corner from England, Daniel Sam!
A giant, looming figure of a man makes his way to the ring from a very old, a very friend of ours, Daniel Sam, the flight heat, old England, from your city of Londonderry.
Well, it really is a dangerous life story, isn't it? I mean, small man versus the big man. Iggy being one of the smaller guys in the tournament, and Daniel being the biggest.
And please welcome to the blue corner from Australia, Iggy McGowan!
Yeah, he said leading up to this fight, he's been watching Zambidis videos, like Zambidis from Greece, who's always the smaller of the guys in tournaments, wants to get inside and try and chop Daniel Sam down.
Well,
Mike Zambidis,
the Greek grenade, we've seen him
fight a few times overweight. Certainly, he's very explosive. And he is very small, but so explosive.
Not saying something.
This Enfusion rules bout will take place in the heavyweight division over three-minute rounds. In the event of a draw, there will be a fourth deciding round. Introducing to you, firstly, fighting out of the red corner. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 109 kilograms. He brings a record of 28 fights, 21 wins. Nine of those wins coming by way of knockout with only 7 losses. He's from England, where he's known as the Warrior. Please welcome Daniel Sam! And opposing him, fighting out of the blue corner at yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 97 kilograms. He brings a record of 16 fights, 14 wins. 10 of those wins coming by way of knockout with only 2 losses. He's representing Australia. Please make some noise for Iggy McGowan!
He has come to make his name in the kickboxing world, and if he manages to
fight the rest of me.
Put Sam down. Yes. Now that would be something, wouldn't it?
Okay. Good hiss. We've got a side to these two. Iggy, not at all intimidated.
Round one, fight!
Round one.
Sam versus McGowan. Hard left kick from Sam. Sam reminds me of that Michael Clark Duncan.
He does,
From the Green Mile.
Yeah.
You're doing the lad on bottles. Hard left kick.
John Coffey.
From Sam, that's right.
Those left kicks are just so powerful, aren't they? Switches more, goes into southpaw, and that's when he's going to start throwing his kicks.
Look at the Australian come forward.
Yes, nice. Slow kick.
Really giving it hard kick with the left side. Daniel Sam using his left leg very well, but McGowan. Still staying in range, not backing off from Sam, is he?
No, not at all. He's not running away. And we saw with Alexander the Russian earlier.
Yeah. Hard left kick again by Sam as he takes centre ring. Just wants to control it.
Yeah, it's very quick, isn't it? Just comes out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Right across into the forearms. Doesn't move Iggy though, does it?
A smile across the face of the Australian.
Break! Close. Fight!
seems to be enjoying himself in there, rather him than me, to be honest. A lot of left and lead from Sam, just bulldozing his way in.
And there's Iggy, just pinning him against the ropes still, trying to go for the shots.
Well, that left kick of Sam's very strong, isn't it?
It's very quick.
Leg kick. A left knee to the midsection of the Australian, but still.
Daniel Sam, more like Muay Thai stylist, so much better with his legs.
Again, sharp jab from Iggy, just has to take a left kick just after that. But he's staying in range, isn't he? He's staying in range and using the angle, hard left kick inside the leg as well.
And then everyone's going to take the toe with a lot of the fleshy part as well, with the inner leg. Oh, there's another one.
But he's smiling.
No.
The Australian's got a smile across his face, as if he's, I don't know, enjoying himself. Like, are you enjoying that?
No, certainly wouldn't. Tough, isn't he?
Yep.
Absolutely. Heart of a lion.
Makes his way forward. But Sam, that left leg, trying to get past that. It's like trying to get past the telegraph pole, isn't it?
It is, yeah. He steps back because that left body can prefer to push it. Tommy can step forward.
He's got some heart though, hasn't he, McGowan?
Yeah. Took some inside kicks there at a later part of that round and some big body kicks. You know, still coming forward.
What you've got to remember is, as well, you can have it all, can't you? But you can't buy heart. No. As my old friend used to say, you can't put bottle in a bottle. Second round coming up then. And Sam ahead, really, but still, I wouldn't write this Australian off because he's not running away.
He gets in close, lets his hands go, it's very dangerous.
Yeah, very quick, nice long running. Good low kicks, but needs to defend that left leg. Body kick of Sam because he's wrecking his arms, it must be.
Madman.
So Australia's hopes rest on the shoulders of this.
Hey, come on!
Little, really, heavyweight. And the hopes of the nation rest on the boulder-like shoulders of Daniel Sam from London, round two. Enfusion heavyweight reality, Koh Samui. Hard leg kick again by Sam. He can kick quick, can't he?
He moves quick as well. Look at these.
Australian looks like he's in trouble here, Kieran.
Stop! Right corner. One, two.
Eliminator. Not mainly for the, just for not answering back, if anything.
Five, six, seven, eight. Fight. Come on. Fight.
Overhand right from the Australian. He starts to go forward on Sam. Ridiculous amount of heart being shown here by the Aussie.
Good
leg kick as well.
Absolutely no fear at all.
No. Long jab by Daniel Sam. Leaping left hook from the Australian. An overhand right. And
that's
another
a nice shot.
He studied Daniel Sam. He said he thought he'd have a way to beat him. But doing it when you're in there is different. But still, you can't write this kid off.
No, you can't. Because he just showed that he's got some lovely uppercuts, inside uppercuts, and outside hooks.
Just takes it hard. He's had a left kick and a right hand. Sam pressures the Australian.
Fight!
Sam very dangerous with those knees. Big legs as well coming up.
Overhand right. Vicky Church screaming, saying, don't let him play with you. But I'm sure Daniel Sam isn't playing in there, and neither's Iggy.
Come on, make your fight.
Yeah, Sam likes to counter all the time.
Yep.
Make you miss. Counter with a long left knee or a left body kick. Another one thrown in.
He's listening as well.
McGowan. Overhand right attempt. Look, this is like you said, Kieran, a David and Goliath story, because he really is trying his best, isn't he?
Good point.
Lovely shot. Left up to the body. But if he sees a left kick back off Sam.
Yeah, Danielson always countering, but sometimes, though, that doesn't score so well. It's more of a Muay Thai score than the actual Enfusion rules scoring.
Exactly.
Let's see a bit more aggression coming forward. Like McGowan, look at these shots. Look at this.
You've got to give this kid credit. I mean, ridiculous amount of heart shown here. As Australia, I'm sure, will be on the edge of their seats watching their heavyweight star.
Another body shot.
Really nice body shot. Good kick to the body as well from McGowan.
Yeah, the pace has slowed down a little bit from Sam. McGowan's, you know,
it's
what he likes.
He's put a lot into it, and he's very hot in here, isn't it? Great shots, and he's still in this.
Stop.
As he goes back on weary legs. McGowan starting to win the heart of the crowd here in Chau Weng Stadium. And if you've just joined us here on Enfusion, I'm Vinny Shawman, and we are watching a mesmerising performance by a smaller, outgunned, but heart of a lion, Iggy McGowan. What a performance so far, Kieran, by Sam. Great performance by Sam, taking nothing away from him. But McGowan showing us real, real heart, isn't he?
Yeah, he's teak tough, he just keeps coming forward. And Daniel Sam's run huge kicks, big knees, but will not have it. Massive heart, this guy.
Yep. Well, there you go then. And as I said, ladies and gentlemen, Enfusion Reality Heavyweight Super Pro Samui kindly training us and helping us with all the people around there, like Sharoon and Chai, all the trainers, Bo,
Noibran,
all the rest, Kang, and we'll start to look at it. So, if you want to go over to Koh Super Pro Samui and you want to learn to fight like these guys and get yourself over and have a look at superprosamui.com. Here we go then, round three, and Enfusion rules, and Daniel Sam switching deftly from southpaw to orthodox, but mainly to use that devastating telegraph pole type leg.
Yeah, it's huge, a quick low kick as well.
And set again, a wry smile across the face of the Australian as he bundles his way forward.
He took an inside left kick there, but tried to throw a huge hook over the side.
Daniel Sam must be thinking himself, what's this kid made of? Because he's took everything, hasn't he, except the kitchen sink?
Yes, he is. Literally took all big shots on the legs as well.
Big really knee. Hard knee. Right hand again from Sam. As he starts to bang the knees in.
One.
Another
two,
count.
Three,
for the Australian.
Four,
maybe five, the writing's on the wall,
six,
right, Kieran?
Seven, eight, one, five.
Yeah, it was mainly more, not so much for being concussed or anything like that. It was mainly just for because he didn't answer back on the knees.
You wouldn't be bothered, would you, if he pulled out here, but he still wants to fight.
He does. Still believes he can get inside. Huge knee, literally lifted the feet.
Huge knee, and he's talented, Sam, as well, isn't he? He knows how to deliver these techniques well.
Right.
But still, the Australian's in this. Look at him going forward on Sam now, trying his best.
Just pressuring all the time.
As he wills his way forward, Sam delivering some very, very heavy knees.
Big knees.
Stop. Fight.
Overhand right from McGowan.
And it's got to be tiresome as well, just hitting 100%. Someone so big.
Yeah. As he starts to deliver heavy leg kicks. But I think Daniel Sam's got bored of hitting Iggy now, hasn't he? You know?
Yeah, I mean, he's clearly
still
ahead.
Still coming forward, though, the Australian. I'll tell you something, you know.
Oh, he's going for the stoppage. Yeah. He's going for the finish.
You wouldn't blame Iggy, would you, to take a knee here, would you? But, you know, he's got to keep his head up. And knees are very dangerous from Sam. But still,
look at
he's
this.
Trying to go over and right of his own.
Unbelievable.
A leaping left hook.
Everything, 15 seconds, 10 seconds,
And you just gotta give so much credit. Oh my goodness. Do you know I've commentated on over 600 fights, and I'm telling you something, that has got to be up there with showings of a heart. Absolutely incredible. Taking nothing away from Daniel Sam. There you go then, a rapturous applause, and justifiably so for both boxers. Good performance by Sam.
After three rounds of engaging action here in Chow Wang Stadium, your judges have reached a unanimous decision. Your winner fighting out of the red corner from England,
Daniel Sam will be glad to see the back of him.
Sam!
He didn't leave him alone, did he?
No.
Just on him like a rash.
He's on him like a tramp on a pork pie.
And can you please show your appreciation for a very brave game man from Australia, Iggy McGowan!
Yeah, so they give him a rapturous applause and justifiably so.
Mummy, I can't remember his name. The big black guy. Yeah, he's going to kick ass. He's going to win. He's going to win the whole thing. England number one, right?
Hey, big man, you did not get your KO this evening.
No, I didn't. I got the win, though, so that's the most important thing. The KO would have been the icing on the cake, but we still got a win, so I'm happy with that.
Did you think you underestimated him?
Not at all. I know he's a strong guy. I've seen some of his training. From his body physique, he's very strong. He could take a lot of punishment, which he did. So I knew he's gonna push through for the three rounds. He had a lot of support out there as well. So I knew he was never gonna just give in.
And what were you thinking when the knees were connected to his head and he was still standing?
Yeah, well, he's sure he's got a big, strong head, strong neck. So he was taking them. I was quite surprised at the end when he continued to take the knees. I thought at one point the rope was holding him up, but still a good win for me, so I'm happy.
And will you be going through to the next round taking any injuries with you?
Hopefully not so far. I don't feel any knocks or bruises, so I'll be good for the finals.
I think this Australian guy he surprised me. He was doing good, but the thing is, he made Daniel Sam tired. He tired him up, but then he let him rest again. So if he keep pressing, he will keep Daniel Sam tired.
That's the Dutch style. That's why the Dutch are the best in the world. Every time I fight a Dutch guy, they don't stop coming.
That's the thing. If you breathe, this oxygen is power. You're not allowed to breathe. So I have to keep pressuring you. No breathe for you.
When you heard it, when you fight Wendell Roach, you're not allowed to breathe. That's why he's the man.
You know, that's what I am.
I knew I was going to be KO'd. I don't give up. That's what I'm here for, on this show.
I've got to say, I looked out first round. I seen you pulling some faces, pulling them towards you. Third round, I looked out and you was eating knees to the face. Is your face feeling okay?
Yeah, I feel fine. I'm here to try and inspire people. You don't give up, no matter how tough things get. You keep going.
And I've got to ask, you must have felt the power in there of him.
I mean, yeah, the guy's got powerful kicks. He's a big weapon, you know? Yeah.
He was looking for the knees to the head. I seen your hands coming down, protecting your body, but I really thought you was going to take a huge knee to the face. I mean, looking at you, you know, you're not too cut up and looking too bruised.
I can't go getting this head bashed up more than it already has been.
Well, you've definitely gone in with a good opponent tonight. You didn't get the win, but how are you feeling?
I feel great. I gave it my all. That's all I can do.
And you're happy with your performance?
There's always things I can work on. That's the beauty of it. And the beauty of fighting, you know, opponents with more expertise, that you grow as a fighter, so.
And do you think you could beat him in the future if you had the opportunity?
I wouldn't be in the sport if I didn't think I could beat anybody, yeah.
If they have to bring anyone back due to injury, I hope they bring you back, man. I've never seen toughness like that, man. Never ever seen anything like that. Amazing, brother.
Appreciate it.
Amazing.
Thanks, man.
Amazing. Heart. Lots of heart, man. Lots of heart.
Thanks, brother.
Psych, guys, you've just come out of the ring, like hitting each other as hard as you can, looking for that knockout, and now you're just chilling, sitting next to each other.
He's
I don't see any reason why they wouldn't be. I've got nothing but complete and utter respect for, you know, Daniel. And I always, you know, even in the lead up to the fight, but afterwards we can actually, you know, verbalise that and communicate that to each other. But, you know, he's my brother, and it's always good to sit and trade war stories.
Yeah, even though you're not in the same team, are you going to be behind Dan in the next section of the tournament?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I support anyone that gets in the ring, you know. Anyone, it takes a lot of... And, I know the power that this monster's got, so, yeah.
Yeah, I say it's, you know, it's a sport. We've been out here for a couple of days with each other, you know, do our training together, moving around together. So, you know, we're in there to fight, but afterwards, before and afterwards, you know, we're human beings. You know, we talk, communicate, share, you know, share jokes, share stories about what happened in the ring, what should have done, you know, what you thought was funny, you know, and then we just move on from it. There's no hard feelings, you know, it's a sport at the end of the day.
Well, it's a cool sight to see you both sat here next to each other, just chilling and talking about the fight.
That's the beauty of Muay Thai, you know, that... You know, I hope that, you know, comes across in the TV show and, you know, all the time. You know, that's what real men are, you know, not ego or anything. You know, treat each other with respect.
Next time on Enfusion.
The same night I come.
The touching story of Thomas.
He died the same night. I can't, I don't have time to meet her.
Warren breaks his nose in training.